Hello again, I'm Mike and I'm the Sports History Collector. Before I get started, today I wanted to give a shout out to a couple of great channels in our community. First one is Drew over at Clean Cheap Shots, and the second one is Robert over at Commenting Collector. Both channels have great content and are very supportive of in the community and of other people's channels. If you don't already, please check them out. So today I'm going to tell you about a little bit of fun baseball history, one for the record books. It was the game in which Tippi Martinez of the Baltimore Orioles set a record by picking off three runners in one inning. But first, a little context. It was August 1983, and the Baltimore Orioles were in a dogfight for the pennant. They were, at the time, 70-52 for the season, which put them in a three-way tie in the win column for second place with the Detroit Tigers and the Toronto Blue Jays, with the Milwaukee Brewers on top of the division by two games. With barely over a month left of the season, none of the teams could afford to give away a single game. That brings us to this fateful day on August 24th, when the Orioles were playing the Blue Jays in a tight ball game. The rest of the tale comes from excerpts from a great story by ESPN's Tim Kirkjian. Tippi Martinez was a very good reliever. He had a 3.45 ERA and 115 saves in 546 lifetime games. He won a ring with the 1983 Baltimore Orioles, and yet he is best known for one game, August 24th, 1983, because he picked off three runners in one inning of a game that Oriole fans voted the greatest in franchise history. "I get asked about it almost every day," Martinez said. The Orioles were playing the Toronto Blue Jays in a big pennant race game. Orioles manager Joe Altobelli had been through his two catchers, Rick Dempsey and Joe Nolan, in order to get the score tied after nine innings. In the bottom of the 10th, outfielder Gary Renicky was playing third base, outfielder John Lowenstein was playing second base, and second baseman Len Sicada was catching for the first and only time in his career. Toronto's Cliff Johnson had homered to start the 10th inning to give Toronto the lead. Then Barry Bonell singled. In came Martinez. "I didn't even recognize our catcher because he was a second baseman," Martinez said. "But Lenny was looking at this opportunity as a whole new career for him as a catcher. He wanted to throw some guys out. I'm thinking, not on my watch or not. I was just hoping he could catch the ball. I couldn't even throw my curveball because he couldn't do anything back there. I just had to throw fastballs on the outside part of the plate. I decided to shorten my move. It wasn't cheating because we knew they were going to run because Lenny was back there. Manager Bobby Cox was going crazy in the other dugout." Martinez threw to first baseman Eddie Murray and picked off Bonell. "The first move on Bonell wasn't even a good one, but he took off for second," Martinez said. "The next batter, Dave Collins, walked. Everyone thinks I walked three guys in that inning and picked them off. I didn't. I only walked one. Collins was really fast. I made a dummy move. Then on the second move, I picked him off. The fans were going crazy." The next hitter was Willie Upshaw. He hit a ground ball to Lowenstein, but he had the range of a dime. "He couldn't get to it," Martinez said. "Bobby Cox was screaming at the first base coach, John Sullivan, to keep Upshaw's foot on the bag. He was screaming that he would send the first base coach back to the minor leagues if Upshaw got picked off. Willie barely took a lead. I was wondering, how am I going to pick this guy off? I've never picked off two guys in an inning. How am I going to pick off three? I made the best move I've ever made. The ball was in Eddie's glove. Upshaw didn't even move. He wasn't breaking for first or for second. He was just standing there. All hell broke loose in the ballpark. I looked at Cox. He had destroyed the water cooler in the dugout. I couldn't believe it." In the bottom of the 10th, Cal Ripken homered to tie the score. Then, appropriately, Sicada hit a walk-off three-run home run to win it. And now for a couple of tidbits. The August 24th game against Toronto was a springboard for the Baltimore Orioles, as they went on to win the division by six games and then went on to the World Series and beat the Philadelphia Phillies 4-1. In the series, Tippi Martinez saved two games, and unfortunately for Len Sicada, he only got one at bat and went hitless. The other tidbit is a pretty cool one. When the Orioles closed Memorial Stadium after the 1991 season, they brought back dozens of players to commemorate it. The players ran onto the field and stood at their primary positions. Len Sicada went behind the plate. The fans got the joke. They cheered and laughed. Martinez smiled. People always ask all the time, how about those three pickoffs? Tippy said. First question, every time. Today from my collection, I've got a couple of 1984 Topps cards signed by Tippy Martinez and Len Sakata. Nice blue ink signatures across the cards. I chose the 84 cards instead of the 83 cards. They're very similar, although I just like the 84 cards a little bit better. The Eddie Murray signed baseball, I got, it's actually a Playing Days baseball. And of course, Murray would go on to become a Hall of Famer. Well, that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the story of Tippy Martinez and his record 3 pickoffs in one inning with an unlikely cast of characters. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.